I'm truly honored to be here, not just because it's a show of Kridai Telangana or just because Hyderabad is rocking, but because of the fact that real estate sector is the largest job producer after agriculture in this country. We as policymakers, we as politicians, we keep thinking about how to create more and more jobs, and real estate sector ends up providing them for us. So I believe it is time for the governments to rethink and for the governments to really hold the hands of real estate developers and give them the respect that the sector deserves. And I'm with you, not only just in words, but in spirit. And I can assure you today, the Telangana government has already been quite supportive of the real estate sector, but will take it forward in the sense of the major demand that has been put forth by various friends present here, that the real estate sector should be given an industry status. I will, from my side as a policymaker, certainly lobby within the central government, also with the state government, to make sure we get an industry status. Today in Hyderabad, if a decent real estate venture has to be taken up, at least 100 crore rupees is required. If at all somebody is coming up with an industry of 20 crore, we give them a great kind of a support, subsidy, loans, bank linkage, tax exemptions, we give them SEZs, etc. from the government. So if anybody is coming up with a 100 crore venture, although it is in real estate, I believe it is time now to move forward and think positively towards this sector. And I am truly proud of the Hyderabad real estate developers. It could be various investors coming from across the country, investing here, developing here, because in the last 4 or 5 years, 2014 from 2000 till 2017, that's the latest figures that I could gather, that we've grossed around 32% in positive in Hyderabad, while other cities were not growing enough. In fact, Delhi was dipping at -60%, Hyderabad was growing at 32%. I can say that this growth can be attributed to the able leadership of our Honorable Chief Minister Garu, KCR Garu, his statesmanly approach in resolving the issues, and his trust in our businessmen. The moment KCR Garu took charge of the state, he had said, we are going to trust our employees, we are going to trust our businessmen, we are going to trust our people, and we will take a very positive approach towards the business and also the employees. So his trust in businessmen led to creating very progressive policies like TSI Pass. And as a result of the TSI Pass, we've seen various global companies coming in here, which indirectly gives a greater push to the real estate sector. Although we could not include you in the TSI Pass, TSI Pass definitely did a lot for the growth of real estate sector in the city of Hyderabad. And as all of you know, Honorable KCR Garu, he assured in a political stability in the state, which is the key concept or which is the key growth factor in real estate business. And apart from that, he's very, very focused on making Hyderabad into a global city. He's been constantly investing in developing Hyderabad. No other governments earlier had taken up this kind of an initiatives. As you are aware, it could be the SRDP, the Strategic Road Development and Elevated Corridor Project, or it could be carving out new districts in and around Hyderabad, like Shamshabad, Yadadri, Vikarabad, etc., or even finishing up the metro lane, and also thinking more about making Hyderabad a world-class city. There is a huge focus and great deal of investment. One difference, I'm sure, since all of you travel across the country and the globe, one difference between Honorable KCR Garu, the Chief Minister of Telangana, and other leaders we have seen is, he's a man of his word. If he says he's committed to the development, he will not only support it in spirit, but also with the resources required. So that is why Hyderabad has been doing great, and I can promise you that it will continue to grow. And his next visionary project is a regional ring road that is going to come up around Hyderabad. This is a 368-kilometer road that we have proposed from the state government. Central government is almost about to give the clearance. State government has also agreed to invest 1,500 crores from our side to make sure this road comes up. Because we created the districts, we want to now connect them with a beautiful road. So this again gives a great push to the real estate sector, is what I can tell you. And apart from this, we as governments, as policymakers, as politicians, we support business people. And why do we do that? Because we expect you to support our people. We expect you to be more transparent. We expect you to give more quality construction to our people. Telangana government is very, very supportive of the businesses because we expect you to deliver a quality output. And especially when we look at the real estate sector, our government is committed to making sure that every poorest of the poor person of Telangana will be entitled to a dignified housing. And in Hyderabad, you have seen about 1 lakh houses are being constructed by the government itself for the economically weaker sections. And I would request the real estate bigwigs present here today to kindly look towards promoting ventures which can give in maybe more houses at affordable pricing. And whatever tax incentives, whatever proposals you will come up with, I'll be very happy to take it up with the government. Because what we need today is to feed the middle class, which needs to buy their own house and to feel the sense of security. Once the sense of security is given to the people, development of the region will automatically come in. So I would truly request you to be a part of this government's initiative. Another world-class initiative taken up by Telangana government is a greening project. It is the world's third largest greening project taken up by our government. And I know you have to mandatorily take up 10% of your land project or whatever and do a greening effort. And I appreciate truly the CREDAI, which has taken up, invested about a crore of rupees in University of Hyderabad. You have planted saplings, now they have grown big. You are spending monthly quite a deal of money to maintain these trees. Truly appreciate you being a part and parcel of government's initiatives. I don't know if you like me for saying this, but I should say this. In a project which is horizontally spread out, we can figure out 10% of land is to be given to greening. But in a project which vertically goes up, I believe the greening should be in proportion to the amount of concrete that you put in. Today we are not doing that. As a result, the temperature of Hyderabad is rising. So kindly look into it. It will be a little bit more expensive. But if we can proportionate the green cover with the amount of concrete that we put in the projects, I think we can make sure Hyderabad remains in temperature wise in, you know, why we love this city is because of its moderate climate. If we have to keep it that way, no matter how much real estate comes in, we need to kindly monitor and moderate the temperature. I would like to please look into that initiative. And the last initiative, which is very close to my heart, and I wanted to request CREDAI to be a part of it. I know that you do work with the skilling of Telangana construction labors, but today the situation is the amount of labor required for the Telangana real estate projects. We are seeing a great influx of labor from Orissa, Bihar, Maharashtra, and various other states. Now, these labor who come in to work here, unfortunately, if they meet with any fatal incidents, there is nothing we can do about it. So I know you are 1%, you pay the government and government is trying to create an insurance fund. But the labor are not aware of these insurance facilities. I request the CREDAI leadership to kindly take it up very seriously to pump up the membership in this insurance initiative. Because you've already paid the money, government already has come up with a scheme, but not many people are availing. Just about only 40% of the labor today are availing this scheme. Kindly let us also together try and work, how do we take care of this migrant labor issues also, because it poses a great deal of questioning on the accountability of government itself. I have seen members of parliament from Orissa coming to me with requests that Orissa labor have died in your state and in some project, and kindly take care of them. So it has become a great ordeal for the government, for the developer also. So let us together, CREDAI and government of Telangana, try and find a solution to this problem. Thank you. While seeking your cooperation in these varying fields, I would like to once again reiterate that my government of Telangana will leave no stone unturned in making Hyderabad a global city. And I will take leave from you with an assurance of continued support from my government of Telangana. Thank you so much. Jai Telangana, Jai Hind.